after the sparkly things. If you do this, you'll be popular. If you do this, you're a nerd. If you do this, you're nothing. We really have pigeonholed ourselves away from all of our vast array of talents. Never, ever, ever, ever think that what God has given you is insignificant. You can bet your bottom dollar there is somebody that needs what you have to offer every single day. Every day, you have something that can change somebody's life. It can be a smile. It can be a compliment. It can be anything, but you have been given the unique ability to change a life. Two most important days in your life, the day you're born and the day you find out why. That moment that you are in harmony with the world. Every person is different. This is Henry B. Eyring. I love this. Every person is different and has a different contribution to make. Just because you're different does not make you wrong. You have something powerful in you. And this is my favorite quote. It's long. By Marianne Williams. And it says, our greatest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that frightens us most. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and famous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people will not feel inadequate. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. And it is not just in some of us. It is in all of us. And when we let our light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. When they see you developing your talents, when they see you finding your armor, that will spark something. It's contagious. Everything's contagious. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. So we are to accept, first of all, that everybody has a talent and gift. We can give each other the grace of not judging other people's. So how do we start that contemplation? We start by stopping the errs with the hers. And what I mean by that is, she's prettier, she's taller, she's skinnier, she's richer. The errs, the bottom, really drag us down. There is not err. There's just, yes, there's everything. Because automatically, if you are saying she's prettier, that means you've already set it up to try to find somebody who's what? Uglier. So you feel like you're not being prideful by looking upward and saying, oh, I'm not as good. We feel like that humility is knocking ourselves down by saying, oh, I'm not as pretty as her. She's prettier. She's smarter. But in doing that, we're automatically saying, but at least I'm prettier than her. She's uglier. And she's dumber. We automatically set ourselves up. That pride comes in even when we feel like we're being the most humble. Isn't that weird? C.S. Lewis, have you heard of C.S. Lewis?
Yeah.
Amazing. He wrote The Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe, but he also wrote some other books that I love. He wrote The Screwtape Letters. And in one of those, he talks about humility. And he says, we have mistakenly led ourselves to believe that humility is the pretty girl thinking she's ugly, or the wise man thinking he's foolish. So no. Humility is being able to rejoice in your own gifts and your own talents as much as you rejoice in your neighbor's talents. It's treating everybody equally. Humility is not thinking less of yourself, it's just thinking of yourself less. It's just letting everybody have their light shine, and that includes you, because you have a light